Welcome to Filmora Pro, a new way to power up your storytelling. In this video, we'll be going over Filmora Pro's powerful animation tools and how to use them. Filmora Pro comes with a few animation presets that you can drop into your footage, which is a great way to get started. That being said, Filmora Pro's animation becomes really powerful once you start working with keyframes. In Filmora Pro, you can change and animate different parameters using keyframes. Keyframes are values you can set to certain parameters like scale, position, rotation, and more at different points on your timeline. If you set a keyframe value earlier in the timeline and then a different keyframe value later in the timeline, your parameters will change from one value to the other over that time. For example, let's make an animation of a square moving from left to right. We can create a square in Filmora Pro by going to our media panel and clicking New, Plane. Let's call this plane square and make it 400 by 400. And we'll color it purple. Finally, let's drag it onto our timeline. In the controls panel under the transform heading, we can adjust the anchor point, position, scale, rotation, and opacity of this object. There are two values for position. One controls the position on the x-axis, while the other one controls the position on the y-axis. First, let's move our square to the left by bringing down the X value. If we want to move from left to right, we need to create our first keyframe and work with the tools up here. Now, there's a lot going on up here, so I'll briefly explain what all these icons mean. We've got our undo and redo buttons on the left, and then our basic keyframe controls. Finally, these six icons on the right toggle what type of keyframe you want to use. We'll touch on these later, but linear is the default type of keyframe. So, moving from the left, let's click the toggle keyframe button, and now you can see a diamond on the position track. Next, let's move forward 15 frames. We can click the diamond icon again to create a new keyframe, or we can create a new one by simply changing our position value again. Let's drag our X position value to the right. Now, when we play the footage, we'll see the square travel from left to right between those two keyframes. We can create as many keyframes as we'd like on the timeline. Let's add one here, and let's add one here. And we can jump back and forth between different keyframes quickly by clicking these two icons on the left and right of our toggle keyframe icon. If we look at our viewer panel, we can see the motion path of our square. We can intuitively adjust the position, rotation, and scale of our square right in the viewer, and even adjust the motion path itself. Finally, if we want to get rid of all of our position animation, we can click the diamond beside position. This will get rid of our keyframes. So as you can see, keyframing gives you nearly endless possibilities for how you can animate objects, and you can keyframe almost any parameter, including most of Filmora Pro's effects. Sometimes it helps to see what your keyframe values look like on a graph, and in Filmora Pro, we can do that by clicking the Value Graph button. As you can see on the graph, our clip scales down from 70 to 60%. If we click on our position value, we see that we also have some position animation later on this clip. There are two lines on the value graph which represent the X value and Y value of the position. You can make your animations a lot more natural looking by smoothing in and out of your keyframes. Right here I have a piece of text that moves up from the bottom of the screen and then returns to the center. Quick note about text clips, you can create and edit text clips by going into the viewer panel and selecting the text tool. So I've got this animation of the text, but the movement doesn't look that natural. The movement is way too robotic and linear. What I'm going to do is go to the keyframe where it goes to its highest, and then I'll clip this filled in diamond icon at the top of the controls panel. This will convert our keyframe to a smooth keyframe. Let's take a look at that. Things look a bit smoother now. If we go back to our value graph, we'll see that there's now a curve going in and out of our second keyframe. We can even adjust this curve to either side if we want our animation to smooth out in different ways. Finally, I want to smooth the last keyframe so that our animation slows to a stop. Back at the top of the controls panel, there's a couple half-filled diamond icons. These will smooth just the animation leading into a keyframe or the animation coming out of a keyframe. For this last keyframe, let's click Smooth In. Here's our final animation. As you can see, smooth keyframes can really help make your animations look a lot more natural. If for some reason we want to change our keyframes back to how they were, we can do this by selecting our keyframes and then clicking the small empty diamond icon at the top of the controls panel to convert them back to linear keyframes. Right here I've got a square with a fill color effect applied to it, which I've animated to have it change between several different colors. As you can see, the colors sort of fade into each other. Let's say we want them to abruptly change between these colors rather than fading. What we can do is highlight our keyframes and then click the square icon at the top of the panel. This will turn these into constant keyframes, which hold the keyframe's value until we get to the next one on the timeline. One way you can make your animations look more fluid and natural is by adding motion blur. I've got this PNG file on the timeline with some keyframes, but the animation is really fast and it feels a bit choppy. Now, this isn't always a bad thing, but sometimes motion blur can greatly benefit the look of an animation. So to toggle on motion blur, we'll want to go up to our clip properties and check the box next to motion blur. When you export your project, you'll see the motion blur take effect, but if you want to see it while you're working, you'll want to make sure that in the viewer panel you've set your playback quality to final. Now let's take a look at our clip with motion blur. You can make 3D looking animations in Filmora Pro with the help of the perspective warp effect. I've got this piece of text on the timeline and I want to create a swing down effect with it. This requires some 3D looking animation to pull off, so let's go to the plus icon beside effects and under warp we'll find perspective warp. Now for this effect I want to make sure my text is relatively centered, so I'm going to head over to the layout panel and under alignment I'm going to click on this icon and this icon to fully center my object. Let's head back to the controls panel. Under our perspective warp effect, let's go to our drop down menus on warp X and warp Y and set them to no. These can be useful when you're warping footage, but they're not really useful here. Now, if we play around with our latitude, swing, roll, and Z distance, we'll see all sorts of 3D animation with our object. And I'm going to reset that. But for this example, we'll focus on the latitude value. For this swinging animation, we'll want to keyframe our latitude value so that it starts up here, and then it overshoots again, and then it rests at zero. So let's begin by dragging our latitude slider all the way to the back and then create a keyframe. Next, let's move forward 10 frames and drag our latitude slider to overshoot a bit. Next, let's go 8 frames forward and we're going to move the latitude the other way and just overshoot a tiny bit. And finally, let's go forward 6 more frames and set our latitude to 0. We'll smooth this out a bit by setting our last keyframe to smooth in and the previous 2 keyframes to smooth. And now we have a swinging animation. Filmora Pro is a great tool for creating custom titles and transitions. Here's the transition graphic I made completely in Filmora Pro using keyframes. If we want to export this graphic to use in different apps, we'll need to export with transparency using a format that includes an alpha channel, otherwise our backdrop will be black. On Windows, you can do this by dragging the uncompressed AVI with alpha or the PNG sequence with alpha preset on top of your edit in the queue. On Mac, you can also do a PNG sequence with alpha, or you can use the Apple ProRes alpha preset. So that's some of the basics of animation in Filmora Pro. Now you should be familiar with different types of keyframes, the value graph, motion blur, and 3D with perspective warp. Make sure to subscribe so that you don't miss out on more tutorials on how you can take your editing to the next level. There's no limit to what you can make.